To proclaim the gospel. eyes of the foolish they seem to have died, and their departure was thought to be affliction, and their going from us to be their destruction, that they are at peace. For though in the sight of men they were punished, their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace he tried them, and like a sacrificial burnt offering he accepted them. In the time of their visitation they will shine forth, and will run like sparks through the stubble. They will govern nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his elect, and he watches over his holy ones. A reading from the Wisdom of Solomon. Let the righteous live forever in the rewards of the Lord. The Most High takes care of them, therefore they will receive a glorious crown and a beautiful diadem from the hand of the Lord. Because with his right hand he will cover them, and with his arm he will shield them. The Lord will take his zeal as his whole armor, and will arm all creation to repel his enemies. He will put on righteousness as a breastplate, and wear impartial justice as a helmet. He will take holiness as an invincible shield, and sharpen stern wrath for a sword, and creation will join with him to fight against the madman. Shafts of lightning will fly with true aim, and will leap to the target as from a well-drawn bow of clouds. And hailstones will wrath and be hurled as from a catapult. The water of the sea will rage against them, and rivers will relentlessly overwhelm them. A mighty wind will rise against them, and like a tempest it will winnow them away. Lawlessness will lay waste the whole earth, and evil doing will overturn the thrones of rulers. Listen therefore, O kings, and understand. Learn, O judges of the ends of the earth. Give ear, you that rule over multitudes, and boast of sovereignty from the Most High, who will search out your works and inquire into your plan. A reading from the Wisdom of Solomon. But the righteous man, though he die early, will be at rest, for old age is not honored for length of time, nor measured by number of years, but understanding is gray hair for men, and a blameless life is ripe old age. There was one who pleased God and was loved by him. He was caught up lest he will change his understanding or guile deceive his soul. For the fascination of wickedness obscures what is good, and roving desire perverts the innocent mind. Being perfected in a short time, he fulfilled long years, for his soul was pleasing to the Lord. Therefore he took him quickly from the midst of wickedness. Yet the people saw and did not understand nor take such things to heart, that God's grace and mercy are with his elect, and he watches over his holy ones.
Please be seated. Reading from the website of the OCA, an article entitled St. Herman of Alaska, Wonder Worker of All America, as we commemorate St. Herman this evening and tomorrow. St. Herman was born between 1756 and 1760 to a merchant family in Russia. His birth name is not known. As a teenager and already a monk at the Trinity St. Sergius Monastery, he had extraordinary spiritual experiences. When a large disfiguring abscess appeared on his neck, making it almost impossible for him to swallow, he thought that death was near. He prayed through the night before the icon of the Mother of God, finally falling exhausted into sleep. He dreamed that the Mother of God healed him, and awakening in the morning, he found that the abscess was completely healed. After 5 or 6 years, St. Herman moved to Valam Monastery, where he loved the place and his brother monks. About the abbot, he later wrote, "Your fatherly goodness, humble one, will be erased from my blessed them for their journey. The 7,300-mile, 293-day journey was the longest in Orthodox missionary history. On September 24th in 1794, the group, Archimandrite Joasaph, Hero Monks Juvenal and Athanasius, Harrow Deacons Nectarius and Stephen, and Monks Joasaph and Herman finally arrived in Kodiak, Alaska. They thanked God for their safe arrival. These zealous men baptized thousands of natives, built schools, and constructed a church. But over the years, the lives of the others were lost in various ways until only St. Herman was left. Choosing Spruce Island for his hermitage and calling it New Valam, St. Herman carried on his missionary work as humbly as ever, but some knew he was a wonder worker. One winter night, a disciple was astounded to see him barefoot, carrying a log so heavy that it was normally borne by four men. St. Herman's holiness enabled him to live in harmony with wild animals and to converse with angels. When asked how he could live alone in the forest, he replied, "God is here, as everywhere. The angels are here as well. With whom is it more pleasant to converse, angels or men?" Angels, of course. His gentleness won St. Herman the love of children, for whom he baked cookies and biscuits. Everyone responded to his thoughtful preaching and his care for their needs. St. Herman protected his beloved native people, whether from severe governors or natural disasters. When a tidal wave threatened to flood the land, he placed an icon of the Mother of God on the shore and assured the people that the wave would not go past it. His prayers kept the wave safely in check. On another occasion, he dug a ditch around his hermitage to protect it from a forest fire. Just as he predicted, the fire was immediately extinguished. And during a terrible month-long smallpox epidemic, he visited and prayed with the victims and their families, urging them to repentance and preparing the dying for the end. St. Herman died, fell asleep in the Lord, on December 13, 1837. That night, a vision of a man rising from Spruce Island into the clouds was seen in various places. Though his body stayed in the warm home of his disciples for a whole month, there was no sign of decomposition. They buried him on his beloved Spruce Island, his New Valam. Even after St. Herman's death, miracles continued. A woman who prayed at his grave in 1907 on crutches and suffering with terrible leg pain found that she could walk unaided and free of pain. In 1842, another saint, Bishop Innocent, prayed to St. Herman when his ship was in danger on the sea as he was returning to Alaska. Soon the waters calmed and the winds became favorable. In August of 1970, Father Herman was glorified as the first North American saint. Metropolitan Irene, Archbishop Paul of Finland, and Bishop Theodosius of Alaska presided at the glorification service. Saint Herman is venerated by the Diocese of Alaska and the entire Orthodox Church in America. Holy Father Herman, pray to God for us. Glory to God for all things.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. promise, O Lord, even as we have set our hope on thee. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. Blessed art thou, O Master, make me to understand thy statutes. Blessed art thou, O Holy One, enlighten me with thy statutes. Thy mercy, O Lord, endureth forever. O despise not the works of thy hands. To thee belongeth worship, to thee belongeth praise, to thee belongeth glory. To the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever,
O Lord of the harvest, who planted the seed of your word in us and watered it with your grace, look upon us now as we work the soil of our hearts, so that the seed that you planted may grow and produce fruit in abundance, both in us and in our parish community. Show us how to build up each other for the work of ministry. Help us to use the talents and abilities you have given each of us for the well-being of your church. Fill us with your Holy Spirit, that our hearts may be aflame with love for you. Enable us to structure our lives and our community, that your love and mercy may more effectively be shown in the world. Inspire us as we gather here in community to worship you. In our daily lives, help us to maintain our fellowship for the building up of ourselves and our parish community. For you are a merciful God who loves mankind, and to you we send the glory. To your Father who is without beginning, and your all-holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. O God, almighty Lord of heaven and earth, and of all creation, visible and invisible, in thine ineffable goodness, look down upon us, thy people, gathered here in thy holy name. Be our helper and defender in this day of affliction. Thou knowest our weakness, thou hearest our cry, repentance, and contrition of heart. O Lord, who lovest mankind, deliver us from the impending threat of this coronavirus. Send thine angel to watch over us and protect us. Grant health and recovery to those suffering from this virus.